sizzle with the USISL in 1995. Boasting a growing number of professional and amateur clubs from coast to coast, border to border, and from corner to corner. Under the leadership and vision of Francisco Marcos, its founder and sole commissioner in its nine-year history, the United States Independent Soccer League moves into the post-World Cup years.
Well, the league was born in 1986 as the SISL. That stood for the Southwest Indoor Soccer League. That's our genesis. We had no idea at the time it would become an outdoor league, as well as indoors, as well as a women's league with 80-some teams, maybe as many as 100 teams by 1995. And all we did was play indoor soccer at the time. We had no real vision. You know, it's very easy to say that we had a vision 8 years ago. I don't want to take any of that credit because there was no such thing. We wanted to have some fun, play the game, and whatever we could become, we would. I guess, like the Army, we really wanted to become all that we could be, and we're hopefully on our way to that. I don't believe that we will become what people would call a major league of soccer. This is not to say that some of our teams cannot and will not, in fact, find a way to move themselves upward to the big time of professional soccer. As a result of that, we will have relationships with the current and possible future major leagues.
Increasingly expanding crowds give the USISL an exciting backdrop. Teams across the country compete annually for a chance to reach the league's prestigious Sizzling Nine National Championship. It's a unique event, bringing together divisional winners to see which team will carry the league trophy into the next season. This past summer, the 1994 season climaxed with the Sizzling Nine finals in Raleigh, Charlotte, and Charleston. After preliminary round competition, the 1994 USISL champion was crowned in Greensboro. A large, enthusiastic crowd cheered the Greensboro Dynamo, who captured their second consecutive USISL title. Dignitaries on hand included U.S. Soccer President Alan Rothenberg.
Well, the existence of the USISL on the professional soccer scene in the United States is fundamental because it creates really the foundation, the base for all other leagues, both second and first division leagues. And so their continued growth and their continued success really benefits everybody up and down the line.
The USISL has become a league of solid clubs, with teams in more than 80 cities, including 35 of the top 50 markets and 15 of the top 25.
The future is very bright. You know, we've grown so quickly, almost quicker than people can believe at times. And now that we have the number of teams that we do across the country, it's kind of a lean and mean time for the league to really develop the strength of each franchise and the overall image of the league so that it's marketable not just to the public, but to corporate America. And with those dollars and revenues, the potential to grow even further.
In 1994, 72 teams participated in the USISL regular season, pouring more than $5 million into the development of United States pro soccer, while spending more than $500,000 on air travel alone. The USISL is a visible, growing means of both regional and local sponsorship opportunities, not only with the Sizzling Nine National Championship, but also with the annual USISL All-Star Game, serving as the league's mid-season classic. A variety of options are also available, with many corporations already throwing their support behind the USISL. Jerseys in Raleigh, Charleston, El Paso, Long Island, Boston, and New York display some of the exposure possible within the USISL. The league can also offer sponsors national exposure on the USISL's growing television network through its 60-minute highlight show, covering the most exciting action weekly from coast to coast and from border to border. Marketing-wise, players throughout the league are being singled out for their ability to sell the sport, while at the same time serving as role models. Nationally, for example, Coca-Cola has found its latest soccer success story in Greensboro. The Garcia brothers of the USISL's Greensboro Dynamo have been thrust into millions of homes across the country.
Show up.
I believe, in fact, that the USISL and all its so-called leagues, its entire system, makes sense. We are in over 80 markets, major, minor, and in between, everywhere in the country. We're in about 38 states. We're in Hawaii, Puerto Rico, and we are now in Montreal, Canada. We have become a community-driven product that can affect, you know, in a very positive way, the youth of our country. And I think that we must make sense, believe that we make sense for a lot of the corporate giants of North America. And we are going to go after some of them. And we hope that, in fact, that they believe that we make sense for them. I really believe that USISL is, in fact, the right league at the right time.
Unanimously considered this country's leading premier professional developmental league, the USISL is offering a springboard for the American player to make a successful transition from the college game to the big leagues. In fact, Mike Aumann, who starred with the Los Angeles Cobras in 1993, is now a fixture with Charlton Athletic of the English First Division. All-stars from 1994 include Rob Ucroft of the Raleigh Flyers, the NCAA leading scorer in 1992, Manuel Lagos of the Minnesota Thunder, the 1994 USISL MVP, and a member of the 1992 United States Olympic team, and Richard Sharp of the Cocoa Expos, the NCAA's all-time leading scorer. The USISL's commitment to American players has put a wide cross-section of athletes onto its various rosters. Several ethnic backgrounds are well represented as the USISL continues to make a large impact throughout the soccer community. Nowhere is the USISL's diversity appreciated more than in El Paso, Texas, where thousands of ethnically diverse fans regularly flock to Dudley Field, home of the El Paso Patriots.
Well, first of all, I think it's very great that we're having this opportunity to play here as a professional soccer player. I think that that's the way, you know, they start something big, and I think they have the teams and they have their organization to start a big league like this.
The USISL also set new attendance records. Minnesota and Milwaukee played before 10,000, and the league as a whole surpassed the 1 million mark in total attendance. From El Paso to Minnesota, from Los Angeles to New York and Florida, the USISL has proven itself as a professional developmental league with quality soccer.
So you've got players who are leaving college, and now 60 or 70 teams at 18 or 20 players. It's developing a much broader base of players than we could otherwise do. And frankly, we'd have to create such a system in order to compete internationally with some of the top national teams and countries from around the world.
It's a very, very tough business, but never before has there been such an opportunity to grow a business on such a sensible level as the USISL represents. It's an exciting time, still a tough business, but many of our teams are now showing 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 people in attendance, rivaling that of minor league baseball.
In 1995, the USISL will continue to expand, splitting into both professional and amateur divisions. It will also feature the first women's soccer league after a successful USISL experiment in 1994, culminated with a national championship. Several United States national women's team players will be demonstrating their abilities, considered the best in the world, once again for various USISL women's clubs in 1995.
The time simply has come. The W League, the Women's League, will have an impact. If we weren't going to do it, someone else would. That's not a good enough reason in itself. We have the best women's program in the world. We've got the best players. With the defending champions of the world, with the upcoming World Cup in Sweden in 1995, the Olympics in 1996, women's soccer is going to get a lot of exposure. Clearly, this is really the right time for a women's league to be launched.
During outdoor soccer's off-season, the USISL continues to feature a strong indoor league, allowing the USISL an opportunity to offer year-round soccer to this country's growing number of talented professionals. Throughout the United States, the World Cup legacy is finding its way into USISL cities.
USA!
As the final whistle blew at last summer's international extravaganza, the impact of both the United States national team's performance and the event itself brought more and more followers into soccer circles. For Commissioner Marcus, this growing number of soccer fans and soccer markets will only serve to benefit the USISL.
We didn't know, we couldn't quantify how the media and the corporate world of America would be affected. We now know that they were affected positively. The television ratings, the success, comparatively speaking, of the American team, all of that is put us into a position where we no longer have to go and feel that we are having to explain what soccer is when we want to talk to a member of the media, the establishment, of the corporate situations. We now feel that we've got something that is viable.
The USISL is offering a vehicle for American players to continue developing their professionals and advertisers and investors to be a part of soccer's growing exposure on local and national levels.
One thing the USISL provides is now an arena for players to not only to continue to play,